Nearly 30 years ago, the film Quadrophenia hit our screens and sparked a massive resurgence in mod culture throughout the UK, but particularly in Northern Ireland. Here in 2007, the mods are still here and they're still as stylish as ever, particularly about their scooters. I went to investigate. Honestly, investigate was the best I could come up with.
This is a modern world. This is the modern world.
You know, on an average frosty Sunday morning, there's nothing I like better than hanging about in an out-of-garage forecourt. But today, I brought a few of my mates with me.
The mod movement originated in the 60s when independence and being stylish were the two most important things for an emerging generation. Then in 1979, there was a mod revival, and a whole new group of teenagers identified with its clean-cut image and music. Now they've grown up with a bit more money in their parka pocket and have reinvigorated the scene.
This is Graham Senior and Graham Junior, the two-man team on the scooter today. Graham, how long have you been riding scooters?
Altogether over 20 years, Joe.
What got you into scootering in the first place?
The music, I suppose, at the start, Joe.
Yeah.
And then just the whole thing of the mod business back in 1979, 1980.
Is this going to be something you're going to pass on to the lad, like?
I can pass it on to him, what he does after that.
How many years you got to wait before you can get a scooter?
Counting up to five.
Counting up to five?
Yeah.
You counting it?
Yeah.
Ricky, you're leading the run today?
Yes.
Where are we going? Tell us the route.
Custom House Square and then on the Starmount.
So, is this the average number of boys who turn up for a run like this?
It's a bit low.
Yeah.
The weather's a wee bit
low. It's freezing.
Just the hardy ones.
Right, well here, we'll get her cranked up and go.
Yep.
Nice. Come on.
Scooter clubs are thriving in Northern Ireland, but as this footage from the 50s shows, even before mods existed, people in this country were falling in love with the charm and simplicity of Italian scooters.
Even riding on the back's amazing.
Just because we get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things ain't too awful.
Talking about my generation.
I hope I die before I get old.
Talking about my generation.
You know what? That is the most fun you can have with your clothes on. All right?
That's right, Joe.
It's still cold, like. I don't think I'm going down well if I arrive naked anyway, so, no. Well, my man Ron here's looking after me. Let's do a wee walk and talk, meet the man behind some of these fine machines. This is Rob. How are you getting on? How's your run going for you today?
It's going well. A bit cold, but
I'm
the rain's staying off.
Both these machines are yours?
Technically.
These are going to take a big part in your wedding, right?
Basically, on the day of the wedding, myself and the best man are turned up. The two Lambrettas.
Wow.
Then after the wedding, we're going out, all the photographs are going to be like me and the wife leaving on the scooters, that sort of thing.
I gotta come speak to this guy, David, over here.
This is a bit of a special machine. You want to see this piece of work?
David.
Joe.
How are you getting on, mate?
Good, mate. Good. Good to see you.
You're well turned out. Good to see.
We're always trying to be well turned out, Joe.
You're not dressed for the weather, though?
Definitely not. But sure. It's better to look good, isn't it, Joe?
This is your baby here?
This is my baby, which I waited for months and months for, yeah. That's just pure Italian gorgeousness, you know.
Were you always a mod? Like, is this something you just got into recently?
No, on the periphery of the scene in the 80s, but yeah. didn't have money back then for scooter, clothes, that kind of thing, so.
Are you in a club as well?
Yeah, Bellevue Lions Scooter Club.
Bellevue Lions. Yeah. There's a couple of clubs represented today. There's the Bellevue Lions, there's the Overlanders.
Overlanders, Pride of the North. I see someone here from the Saints, Hope and Glory, Norsemen, away from the numbers. You could round them off. There's a load of clubs at the minute, you know.
This is Zeb. You must get some reaction on this.
Oh yeah, especially in Ballymena.
That's a whole lifestyle thing for you. This is your life, it's your passion. Yeah.
It's a passion, it's the image, it's the only youth movement that can't be look back upon as with any form of embarrassment.
Yeah.
You know, and for a lot of people, it just really cuts the cloth.
This is Emma Jane. Emma Jane's come down with her dad, Dino.
Hey there.
This is something else, man. Unbelievable. Thanks. Safety, assume you're a Stevie Wonder fan? I mean, there's incredible engravings and stuff.
Three of my friends
done the paint, the engraving and the chrome.
You see, this is a future here, not a future girl scooterist.
It is indeed.
All right. You a big like Stevie Wonder and Small Faces fan and all?
Yeah.
Yeah. Who's your favourite though?
Britney Spears.
We'll get a Britney Spears
Britney
scooter.
Britney Spears.
Done
yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
We'll get a pink.
Yep.
We'll have Britney along one side, Emma Jane along the other.
Without further ado, we were mounting up and heading off around town again. So what do these guys do when they're not on their bikes? Completing the authentic experience, there are now regular Northern Soul and Mod nights like this one in Belfast. The faithful can relive and celebrate their culture through the power of socialising.
The music is a big part of it. I mean, it's such a cross-section of music from the 60s to the 70s, 80s and even, you know, current stuff today. We've had this going for 2 years now, but there have been clubs like Mods and Souls who've been going for years and years. Guys like that deserve a tremendous amount of credit and praise for keeping the thing going.
Today, the biggest factor keeping the scene alive is the internet. Mods keep in touch via forums and emails, and sometimes scooter rallies include as many as 150 riders. On this cool winter day, we had just over 50 bikes, and I have to say, it was an amazing experience.
Now, you can say what you like about this, right? Maybe there's not as many women involved as you would like. Maybe some of the men here, like myself, have less hair and more waistline than they would like, and you do get a fairly vicious breeze around your unmentionables. But I'll tell you what they do have. Great crack and passion. That's all you need.
We are the most. We are the most. We are the most.